board has questions for the fire department at this time that we want to ask? Kind of just take it on.
One thing that I've asked the assistant chief is that, you know, we need to figure out what our regulations are since now the state gets involved in this, as far as minimal standards on apparatus and stuff like that. It's different than what San Antonio has, being it's a ESD board. But anyway, we need to figure all that out before we start doing a bunch of work on vehicles. So just a common sense, practical, economical approach to that. So we don't want to do something and have to redo it or sell the vehicle because it doesn't comply with anything we can do. So that is something that I did mention to the assistant chief.
Well, maybe right now would be a good time to have an open discussion. Just saying, we've got the fire department representatives here, the board here. Maybe ask them what their thoughts are on that, sir. Because I understand right now they are bound by strictly volunteer regulations.
That's FFMA.
So what happens when a department goes part volunteer or part paid? Those are questions maybe someone knows the answer to.
So the question I have, and I'll just throw it out there, is being that we're now going to levy a tax on the citizens of ESD 5, and at some point that's going to kick in, which I believe October the 1st. But once that happens, we no longer, I say, as a volunteer fire department, we got to comply with a different set of standards than what the volunteer fire department does. And the same thing with ESD 4. They've got, with whatever they're going to have to, especially with equipment and different stuff. So my question is, okay, how do we get between now and October the 1st, get the transition where maybe we're not spending money now that we're going to have to re-spend later, if that makes sense. Or spending money on something that we're not going to be able to use because the minimal standard is different. Let's just say just by year, that vehicle's tapped out. You know, I know we got a 1987 pumper, I believe the discussion was. You know,
yes.
You know, at 20 years or 30 years, that might tap out, whether it's got 10 miles on it. It just might just tap out because that's just the way the minimal standard is. So those are some of the questions that I have. Can't tell anybody what to do prior to October 1, but I would just say that, you know, we can help each other out when October 1 gets here as far as what I guess the ESD can accept and what we can't accept, if that makes sense, without having to spend more money. So that's just a discussion that we're just going to have to dive into that deal. I know we're all new to this ESD stuff. Pretty much ESD 4 is, ESD 5 is. I know nobody on this board, per se, is set up in ESD. I do know that there's multiple that have been set up within the county. We don't want to make the same mistakes they've made either. So that's my two cents on the whole transition piece of that deal, and we all got to work together and try to make it as seamless as possible. And the volunteer fire department is going to need us as well as we're going to need them. So we just got to throw it up in the air and keep throwing it up in the air until we kind of figure it all out. So.
All right. Is there any other discussion on that?
I think this is an opportunity for y'all to have as much discussion as you want. I would say, I would ask the FFD, what the volunteer fire department, what their expectations are, and maybe convey what y'all's are. Because the next time I'll be meeting.
Right. So as Mr. Caldwell mentioned, I guess I'm not asking what your 2-year plan, what your 5-year, and what your 10-year. As of right now, what do you want? Obviously, I think Ryan did bring up a good point about our equipment that you have. You know, is something going to be no good in a year? Is something already not no good? Mm-hmm. We can't use no more.
It's possible those engines are not in compliance.
Is it 20 years?
That's what we don't know. Yeah, within 28, it's like you can fix it all up to 27, and 28 is dead.
So that's why I said, there's some of them going to be tapped out. I don't know. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's a question that needs to be asked.
I've got a question before
you. Can I ask a question?
Sure. Is there an accreditation service that for fire departments? I know police departments have it.
There's different ways to be accredited, and you can bring an outside firm in to look at your equipment and tell you what you have to do to meet the state code and so forth.
So as far as accreditation goes, San Antonio's an accredited fire department. You gotta jump through hoops to get accredited. That's accredited. So that's a whole separate deal.
Well, I know that's going big, but it should have your basic as far as your equipment stuff.
That would be your NFPA standards.
Yeah. So you think there should be a company that does a survey on what you have to tell you where you stand with everything?
I put money on there, somebody out there that does it.
To meet the minimum of what the ESD is required.
Exactly.
And that's what we need to get our hands on, what is required of the ESD.
Mr. Caldwell, am I off base here?
No, but I mean, I can tell you right now what's required of the ESD is contained, right? In chapter 775.
Yeah.
Now, what's required of the district versus what is required from how we're providing services, those are different bodies of legislation. Okay? If we have a volunteer department that we're funding, then we're going to follow those regulations that either the TCFP or what was the other one?
SFFMA.
That lays out. The district itself, from this is the lofty perch of this table, 775 is what governs us. I'm not exactly sure. I have never seen anything that states we can't accept something because it's not going to work.
If we contract with a volunteer fire department, mm-hmm. they go by SFMA. Mm-hmm. But being now it's the taxpayer money of the ESD, do we have to raise them to a higher standard and go to TCFP?
Let me ask you, Acting President. This ESD doesn't want to be a volunteer department.
No, we want to push it to.
We want to be
full-time,
at least part-time pay.
Right.
So we are going to make our service providers. They're going to come to live up to our standards, and we have to get them to our standards.
Right.
Because they're not there yet.
So I think the voters, to answer that question, the people who voted to, obviously we're an ESD, 4 and 5 now. So we automatically go to a different standard than a volunteer fire department. We don't have the option to say, you know what, we don't want your money. Guess what, we're going to stay volunteer. We don't have that option.
Yeah, but there are ESDs in Texas that are strictly volunteer.
Well, I understand that. No.
West Texas,
don't get me wrong, like strictly that. Volunteer. But as far as when it comes to equipment and different stuff, that's kind of what I'm talking about. Yeah, there's multiple departments, ESD departments, that are all volunteer. And then there's some that are part volunteer, part paid. You know, there's no doubt that an ESD district can't walk in and say, guess what, we're going to be a paid department. Hey, that just doesn't happen. You don't got enough money.
Right.
I mean, you do the math on that, there's not enough money to do that. So that's why I said, we got to rely on y'all, and y'all got to rely on us. You know, I guess the best way to say it is, look, we can bring everybody up to standard, whether it be training, equipment, whatever, with the tax that's fixing to be levied. But on the flip side, we can't say, you know what, we don't want no personnel because we don't got enough money to do it. So that's why I said we all got to work together in all of this. So if the best way for me to explain it is, let's become in a practical way, a hyper-volunteer department. In other words, we're going to try to get the best equipment we could get within reason, but yet still be a volunteer department. For now, don't get me wrong, in time we're gonna have to transition to something else.
Mm-hmm.
But right now we just can't say, oh, guess what, we're gonna pay 10 hours a day, 12 hours a day. I don't see that we're gonna generate enough revenue to do that.
Well, plus if you go over 15.
Look, Mr. Jacobs, you had a question you didn't ask.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yes, sir?
What, that man right there, I'm sorry, I don't remember your name.
Ken Cawthorn.
Ken? Do y'all have, since you're a volunteer fire department, there are certain regulations you have to meet, correct?
Yeah, the SSFMA, you know, like we've seen.
Okay. Are y'all audited every couple of years to find out if y'all are up to standards?
No,
does the city require anything since y'all work with the city? I'm just curious.
No, they never, well, that I can think of. I'd have to go through the contract and stuff, see what
In our contract with the city, it does specify some things.
It does,
we're supposed to, our, excuse me, the fire department is supposed to have so many trained personnel. It does have some levels of criteria.
And y'all met all of that?
We have some personnel that are both SSFME, Walter here.
Okay, but y'all are following what they said, okay. But then the city is required by the state, or they just make up their own rules?
Actually, I don't know on that part.
Okay.
I would say probably by the state.
Is it worthwhile, what that man said right there, Ken, I'm sorry, to get a company to come in here and actually audit and look and see exactly what you need that will meet state requirements?
I don't see the harm in doing it. Maybe it gives us some information on what we have and what is required.
How hard would it be for you to do the equipment ourselves? You don't have that much out there.
We'd have to go through.
That much to do it.
We'd have to go through. My friend Walter, and FDA, make sure all.
Yeah, so the NFPA governs your structural firefighting equipment. That basically takes your brush trucks out of the equation. NFPA standard is 10 years for a fire engine. Can be pushed to 20 as long as it maintains operational functionness and pump testing. Pumps, ladders, all the equipment that's on there continues to pass, you can push it up to a 20, and at 20 is the absolute cutoff per NFPA.
So we're out of luck on engines. So some of these engines out here are over 20.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Anybody got a couple $1 million they want to loan?
Yeah, so but I go back to the first question, is we kind of need a hard copy of inventory of what we got. In my opinion, what we got, I mean, that's just, hey, this one is this year, here are the maintenance records for the 20 years or whatever. I get that. Man, that's perfect. But it kind of gives us sitting up here, I think it gives us a very good
idea
overview on what kind of outlay, dollar outlay, we're going to have to.
Last month, didn't y'all get some type of inventory sheet?
We got a budget. I still like that man's, Ken's idea about bringing an independent organization in here.
Third party liability.
And audit your equipment.
That's fine.
And then they can go over everything. And then we have a hard copy, third party, as Jeff says, then we know exactly where you and I stand. And that's the best thing we can do.
Yes, I live in Houston. And right behind me is Shelton Volunteer Fire Department, which is an ESD, and it operates just like you all are proposing, a hybrid. They're volunteer and paid. They have a paid crew, they have a volunteer crew. And I know the chief, I can contact him for you and see if he's willing to talk to you all.
That's why I kind of said we don't want to make the same mistake somebody else has made.
Well, they've been operating for years. At least 15 years, I know.
We've also got multiple other ones that have done it closer to Houston within our county. So I think that would be our first start. But there's no use having knowledge from everywhere. Based on what, you know, Larry asked a very good question, the insurance companies that insure the city, that give the city of Floresville an insurance rating, has had to have some type of look at the volunteer.
They've been here.
Yeah, so I mean that might be a decent place to start. What was the last ISO report that the city got to base their insurance on? I mean, it gives some type of a. I know that's happened. So.
Is the fire department, y'all willing to try and hunt somebody down that could do that? And get that taken care of?
Do you have any recommendations on that, Tom?
I'd be honest with you. You pay me to be plain spoken. I don't see why you need that. You know what they have. You can go out there and look at it. You know the valuation of it. This isn't a business transaction where we're going to make them an offer. We know what we're going to need. If they don't have it, we're going to have to get it. If they do have it, there's a way we can fix it. And that's something to look at.
But what do you think?
Either way. I mean, I see his thought, his views. I understand yours and Mr. Ken over there. You know, somebody other than us, you know, looking at.
I still like the third party idea.
Right.
And let y'all off the hook, and it lets the ESD off the hook. In other words, we have a third party independent review, and therefore it gives us traction on what we need to do.
I said it doesn't let you off the hook, it just lets you less humble.
We know what's out there. There's no question of what's out there.
Mr. President, I don't. Does the ISO report or rating list that stuff?
I don't know. Do we have a copy of that? Or does the fire department have a copy of that?
I don't see.
The city has got to get one at times, so it'll say, okay, well.
I don't remember the last time we.
That says their insurance rating for the city, for with the city. Now that doesn't take into account county, but it does
just the city.
Take into account the city.
Well, it takes into account the county too, but I don't know how to on that part. Now.
I got something on that. Even a third party company coming in is still going to use the NFPA standards, which you can get on the internet. Go to your NFPA standards for apparatus. It'll tell you everything it's supposed to have to be class 1, class 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, whatever. And it'll give you the years and the breakout points when it becomes a primary engine, first attack, or a secondary reserve engine. Both your engines are at 20 plus, I believe, which are going to be at best a reserve engine at that point.
So then is TCFP, they go by what NFPA states, right?
Pretty much.
Well, there's our guidelines now. We got to go by NFPA.
Mm-hmm. That's always been.
Everybody goes by NFPA.
And that's who we need to go by. There's our.
I mean, even if we get a third party to alleviate, you know, any question we have, we've had a third party do it, they're still going to go off the NFPA standards. Mm-hmm.
That's correct.
And I get the NFPA standards and TCFP, but the guidelines for a municipality department, the ESD district, and a volunteer are different.
Well, that's true.
That's the original question I asked when we started this whole conversation is, what are our guidelines when it's concerning the ESD-5? Our minimum standards, I don't care what kind of equipment it is, it's going to list it.
That's something we're going to have to
come up with. We don't come up with it. Somebody's already came up with it.
If you go on the ISO website, it'll actually give you a breakdown.
Back to the ISO.
It gives you a breakdown of what classifies as a type A engine,
I get
rescues, and those are kind of the things you look for, look toward as far as.
But as an ESD district, how many type whatever units do we have to have? Or do we have to have any? Do we have to go to, can we have ones, two, threes, what?
Ryan, I think if you go through, I mean, the section 775 is what governs.
I get it.
And I everything I haven't read from front to end yet. Trying to go through everything to see where we're at, what's what.
Right.
And I don't really see, I don't know, Tom, if you, it's not real specific.
I haven't
seen anything. It's pretty much the ESD, the state created and set it there, but there's not really no, you know, how. I think we may be asking a question, well, what does ESD have to do as far as equipment? I don't really think there's nothing that says, from what I've read so far, you have to go by TCFP, you have to go by NFPA.
Well, that's a question. I mean, if somebody says, okay, y'all going to come up with your own stuff, great. All right, that's something that we all got to discuss.
I think it has, whatever we come up with, it has to be within the guidelines of the NFPA.
Because it appears that's what everybody goes by.
Well, NFPA's on the equipment and the training. Now, looking ahead, are we going to become a combination department?
That's
if we are, then we're going to have to go by TCFP guidelines. Yeah. Even the volunteers.
Yeah, everybody's going to get to that.
Volunteers will be on SFMA, and stipend guys will be SFMA up to $7,500 a year. Anything over $7,500 a year, you're considered an paid employee at that point. So, if you're volunteers are all SFMA certified, fire 1, 2, you can be drivers, the whole nine yards, but your paid guys got to go by TCFP standards, which means your department will have to go by TCFP standards, and they take their guidelines on equipment out of the NFPA. So it's up to the board and the department to get together and say, hey, in a year, we're going to start out as a volunteer department, we're going to be, like he said, you know, a hot volunteer department with really good stuff, but in a year, we're going to put some paid full-time guys in the seat, and we're going to become a combo department with volunteers still in the department in manning the engines and everything else. So the guidelines at that point will have to be we need to know where we're going to go to start with.
Or on the flip side, we get people trained up to wherever we have to be, even if it's still an all-volunteer deal.
Yep.
But what I'm saying is, at some point, we're going to have to reach a standard.
Hmm.
Right. You know?
Well, I think we ought to go for the highest standard to begin with.
Well, I get that.
If we can afford it.
That all costs money.
Right.
So, anyway.
There's grants out there you can get for the schools.
But, yeah. Oh, no.
Chief, can I ask a question?
Yes, sir.
Does your department have any type of accreditation or certification process with the state of Texas? You all have had to undergo and you have to maintain?
The, what do you call it, Texas Firemen's and Fire Marshal Association.
Firefighters are not in the state Fireman's Association.
They're trained. This is the department itself.
No.
And it's the Texas State?
Texas Firemen and Fire Marshals Association.
State Fire Marshals Association. Because I know that EMS service providers have to have, basically almost, it's licensure from the state. Fire departments, I thought that they did, but to your knowledge, they don't?
No.
Okay.
You're supposed to be trained and qualified to go in, say, a structure fire. You're supposed to be, but...
But there's multiple ways you can get that certification.
Right.
Yes. You can do both online or go to a school itself. Or, again, you go through the State Firemen's Fire Marshal Association, or you advance over to TCFPA.
I think as a board, we got to, how you get your trained guys there, how they're going to get there, what they're going to do is kind of up to the department, maybe.
No, I think it's going to be
how guys have to be get those, have to be certified. They have to be certified or trained.
I think it's going to be up to us.
Well, that's what I guess we need to figure out how we're going to set our board up. What are we going to do?
No, I get that. But that's a discussion that we're going to have is, okay, this is where we're at. This is our first goal. This is maybe a two-year goal. I get all that. But that's something that we can't, they can do, I guess you shouldn't say, whatever till October the 1st.
No, it's January 1st.
It's January 1st?
You start collecting taxes in
October 1st. Okay, so January 1st, but then
what you may be considering is the Floresville Fire Department will not have a contract with the city as of October the 1st.
Yeah, the January 1 deadline is kind of shaky for beginnings, never set, but technically the budget year for the department will end on September 31st. The 30th, in October the 1, the 1st, the city's not going to provide them any money or contribute it, at least the last that I was told.
All right, then you're going to have to borrow some money.
Well, I would assume the fire department's not going to quit making calls.
No.
The fire department can probably continue to operate for some months. They're not going to ditch and leave everybody. Now, I think that's where we need to set, am I correct, what our fiscal year is going to be, correct? Now, obviously, we're not going to have no money till unless we borrow or.
Well, you're gonna basically have to set a budget anyways this summer.
Correct.
That's got to happen.
Right.
You know, the district is already, the people in the district are going to pay taxes for this year. The collection will start in October.
First
distribution will be somewhere around November time frame. Our treasurer and our assistant treasurer might want to reach out to banking institutions. There are ways to borrow money. I think the board should set a guideline of October 1 to start providing the services with the Floresville Volunteer Fire Department.
Contracted with
the Floresville Volunteer Fire Department as a service provider. And in the meantime, but right now, we need to kind of come up with strategic expectations, strategic vision for this organization. And then we figure out how we're going to get our service provider incorporated in that and start. October 1 is day one, 18 months from that, whatever your timeline to get this stuff resolved.
All right, well, we've had a lot of different options here, Jeff.
Yes,
sir. So what's the first thing we're going to tackle?
Well,
that elephant's big. We can all take a bite.
That was my.
That's
my opinion too, because of the fact that we talked about it, and we're probably going to end up doing it anyways. bunk gear. We're probably going to order bunk gear pretty soon.
That, but see, that's on a strategically wise, that's kind of not where we're at.
Yeah.
That,
but for us on our side.
That's more of
our side is, I think, and correct me if I'm wrong, is how are we going to, with these guys, how are we incorporating? Where are we going to go? How are we beginning? What is our part as the board?
So let me just.
And what are they going to do? How are we going to work it together?
Let me throw this out here, and I'm just going to say it. Y'all got X amount of dollars in the bank. Yes. Did y'all earn? Y'all fundraise? Yes. Whatever.
Correct.
Come October 1, we're assuming we're going to contract with y'all. I get that. So how you spend your money prior to that, if you want to buy bunker gear, new BAs, I get that. But at some point, we're going to have to contract with y'all. We're going to contract with y'all, or we might contract with you. Let's just say it that way. Then your funding mechanism changes, yeah. And that's going to be up to us and y'all through negotiation how much that funding is going to be or whatever. So that's on the strategic part of our part of that deal. But objectively, between now and October 1, how you spend your money is up to you. So you want to buy bunker gear or BAs? I know that's been. And putting another tank on that six by, I mean, that's up to y'all. That's y'all's money, obviously. So I get that. But on this side of the deal, we're, in my opinion, we're trying to set this deal up, you know, very rational and very common sense kind of a way, so that the transition on this deal is relatively easy with some type of forethought as to, okay, well, 2-3 years from now, we might be a combination department, or a year from now, I don't know. So, but that's just stuff that we're going to have to work out.
Yeah, Mr. Jacobs?
First thing we need to do is find out what the condition and all the equipment is. Get it out of the way. We're going to set up an office where we're going to be. Mailboxes.
Well, that's coming up.
Yeah. All right. And then strategically, they can run until October. Strategically, we should have a plan in effect by October 1st. What they're going to do next year for our funding. But we need to know what is here. We need to know who owns what. Get everything ironed out. That should be our top priority right now.
I agree with you on that. I think we should try to have this ironed out before October 1st.
This, yes. What the basis.
We need to have.
But the strategic, I would think, when we go into next year of what we're going to ask of them, that would be another meeting down the road.
Sure.
So, but they've been very cooperative. They've done a hell of a job, and but they can run till October 1st. And looking at the gentleman's budget for next year, that's already gave us something to go on.
Yeah.
We're not going to build Rome in a day, but that was a very budget. Gives us something to run on next year. And so anyway, but we need to find out what the condition is. Now, y'all talking about 20 years? You got to ditch this stuff. That's what I'm understanding. Well, how many hundreds of thousands are you looking at? Everything is over 20 years old. But we need to find out what regulation we're following. Y'all done talked to three of them so far. You know, NFPA, the TCFP, and I think there was a third one. But are we required, and since we're going to be a taxing entity, we're going to have to replace all this stuff. And we're going to have to go borrow some money, which is another issue. So, but let's find out first what we're going to follow, what our equipment condition is. I 13,000 miles only on a, what was it, 85 model, 87 model? Wow, wish my cars would last that long. But that's what we need to do first, find out what we got. And maybe walk.
That's too bad, so, that equipment, I mean, it's in good condition. You know, there would be some.
Well, I think we definitely need to be sitting down and having more conversations with the fire department. Obviously, we need them, they need us, no doubt.
Yeah.
So I think we're going to answer a few questions when we get to C.
Right.
So when we're done with C or whatever, I think, as our attorney said, we need to talk about some strategic things on things we need to be done prior or that we might need to really discuss in the next meeting.
Right. As far as, we got a financial institution, like I said, I don't know what we got on C. I wasn't at the last meeting or who looked into that. But I think once we get through C, or at least I'll have a little more understanding of where we're at.
Are we good on our discussion on letter B with the fire department? We good there for right now, everybody?
I think we're all in agreement or somewhat agreement. We need to just see what we got.
We don't need no motion to move on, do we?
Maybe. Do you have that list, Megan?
Okay.
Then we need to show them the equipment.
Do you want the fire department to hire? For us to hire? I don't see at this point we're in a position where we could hire one.
No.
No, we're.
If you put money in your funds.
Yeah.
This is our short-term plan.
Okay.
Well, I don't think, I would not.
Then we'll get you one everybody last time.
I don't know.
We're required. We come up with the money.
But I think before we do that, make a motion to do that, then we need to move on with our financial.
Yeah.
Borrow money. Or you want to put somebody, you want to put a, do we need to develop a committee to look into that? Figure out how much it's going to cost? We need to know how much it's going to cost before we start.
We got, would have to be from your.
We've also got another fire department too. Was Canada Verde?
Yes.
Well, we managed.
Together, I mean, I guess it's. We don't, I mean, we got more equipment than other than just here to discuss.
So over there, we have a brush truck and a five-ton.
Yeah.
And engine three is over there.
Yeah, well, that one needs to be.
That one needs to be pumped, doesn't work on that one.
Right, so again, there's equipment and issues that we, until we, I guess, figure it out. But I agree with Mr. Jacobs. We've got to have an inventory of what we have and where it stands as far as regulation goes. Okay, if we got to replace all, what's that going to cost each piece about? That's all discussion. Those are all discussions that we're gonna have to have. But in to answer, that's hundreds of thousands of dollars. There ain't no doubt. Y'all know that. It's what we do. That's
yeah.
It's a lot of
money. Yeah. So as a board right now, do we want to? Does somebody have a motion they want to?
Well, item B is a non-action item.
Yeah.
Well, that's why I was asking if we move on, because I didn't see anywhere talked about.
I think it's a non-action, but we can't, to Mr. Jacobs' deal, I don't think we can require y'all to have an audit or have an independent third party come into that. We can't do that. Now, we can say we can hire somebody to do that if we can fund it as a board to come in and look at their stuff.
What if they offered
it? We could do this as a board and the fire department combination if y'all want. What? Go out there, find out what the NFPA requires. Go out there, sit down and look at this. But
as of right now, we don't have any funding mechanism to even say, hey, we'll pay for that or whatever.
Yeah,
we don't have that.
You can borrow money, according to an attorney here.
Yeah.
No,
but we need to figure out if we're going to borrow, what are we all doing to make sure we get enough to function for whatever we're going to do?
Yeah.
What's that?
I say if we're going to borrow some money and we're going to get us a startup loan going or whatever you want to call it, we're going to need to know, okay, what are our other deals that we're going to need to do that we need this money for to make one lump sum?
You don't need to borrow it all at one time.
You have a line of credit.
Well, yeah, you can.
You say, okay, I need this, I need this, then later on I need that.
We're going to have some kind of a max goal to it.
Yeah.
How much you worth, Jerry?
Yeah. A few pennies.
Real estate overlay.
Can I pose a question to the board?
Yes, sir. Go ahead.
I've heard a lot of talking back and forth, but maybe one simple question that the board needs to determine the answer to dictates what else you'll do, and that is, what level of service is ESD 5 going to provide on October 1st?
Well, that's what we're trying to find out, Doug.
What level is it? Y'all need to
figure
that
out.
We're trying to figure that out.
Volunteer service? Yeah. Well, you have one already.
Well, I think there's no doubt it's going to have to be the volunteer service. There's no other option for us.
Okay, so that's it?
At this point.
Then they're operating right now.
Right.
Right.
And they're operating lawfully right now.
Right.
So what do we need to do audits and all this other stuff?
To find out.
Due to our capital improvement plans, things like that, I see that. But to just enter into a contract with a volunteer service provider who's sitting right here already doing it, I'm not quite sure I see why that expense is a great idea.
I guess maybe as far as what Ryan is saying is, now that we're in ESD, is there the other standards?
So
if we contract to them, they have to be meeting those standards.
I'm going to say this. ESD can't contract with Ryan Bippert Fire Department.
Why not?
Well, I'm just, okay, we can, but I'm going to have to meet some type of standard.
you need to meet the standard that the district sets, and you also need to meet the standard that governs the type of entity you are.
You're right. So I think my whole line of questioning is, when we say, okay, we want to contract with Floresville Fire Department, are they going to meet what the state one minimally says that we have to do? If we're saying we're going to set that, okay, that's fine. That's a discussion we're going to have. I don't know that answer. But we're going to find that out, obviously. I don't know. And we've also had a lot of discussion of equipment that's elderly, experienced, to say the least.
Experienced.
Can they even use the same equipment? I know they're a volunteer fire department, been operating, but will they follow? We're levying taxes on the taxpayers of the state of Texas. That comes with a cost.
Yes.
And the state of Texas just doesn't let you do that and say, oh yeah, y'all go ahead and keep operating as a volunteer fire. We're just going to contract you. If they find, okay, I get it. But are they going to say, okay, well, during this transition period, we got to get up to at least have one type one or class A pumper. I get that. So there's some stipulation. I don't know the answer to those, Tom. I really don't. But it's a question that we're going to have to find out.
I understand
what you're saying is, you know, they're already operating. Let's contract with them now or try to get that done October 1 and then transition through that. I get kind of what.
But even if we're taxpayer funded and Amudis and whatnot, we have to go with those guys because those are going to be the only way we're going to provide it. We don't have the funds now.
I know that.
So I mean, think you're going to have to just bite the bullet and go for a bit till we can get it there.
Again, I made the statement earlier, we're going to work together. Maybe we got to get some equipment so y'all can keep offering the service. I get that. Maybe we got to help y'all get some training so y'all can keep operating. I don't know the answer to either one of those two questions. And nobody here does either. We've all had discussions about having a third party come in, talking about the ISO rating. All of those things we're going to have to figure out. And if we can continue to help y'all help us as a ESD5, great. Why would you not want better equipment, better training? I mean, and Kenny DeFine, that's the most economical and common sense way to do that.
The way I look at it right now, if we can, we talked about gear, you know, bunker gear, possibly applying for, we'll have to apply for, what do you call, SCBA grants, you know.
Sure.
From here to October, we're going to need some equipment and stuff, especially bunker gear. We're willing to buy that stuff with the money we have.
Sure.
Because we're going to continue providing service for this community, you know.
Right.
That's what it all comes down to. And in the meantime, as y'all ramp up, you know, we'll gonna have to meet you or try to meet you at the same.
Sure. I agree.
I think we all agree that we've got to work with the VFD to make it work.
So. Sure.
All right, let's see. Let's move on from B. Let's go to C. There's no action to be taken on B. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Let's go on to C on the agenda, which is reports, discussion, and possible action regarding matters individual board members and board attorney were investigating regarding information to technology such as the email, website, securing an official address, and retention of financial institutions. We need to get an address established. I personally really think we should do a website, get it going, just because we can post our agenda there. I've been reading through, I've been watching some videos on that safety website deal.
Safety.
Yeah, it's about 2.5 hour. One video I'm watching, about halfway done with it. Things that we should be doing, need to be doing, how it works.
So
we definitely need an address. We need to have our administrative office. We're supposed to have that within 60 days of being created.
So let me ask you this. Did anybody go to Galveston to that?
No, none of us did.
That conference that they had in Galveston?
Some of the department did,
but nobody on the board did?
Yeah.
Okay. I wasn't sworn in early enough, otherwise I'd have went to that. But so you asked three questions there. Let's start with one of them.
I'd say we need to get an address. What are we going to use? What?
What can
we had prices. Mr. Jacobs had gotten prices on a P.O. box. Okay. There again, that's a paid deal. We would put the bill for that to start with. Here's the monthly deal. You know, how soon are we going to get some funding?
Where do y'all get y'all's mail?
At the P.O. box.
We have a P.O. box.
Okay, let me get this off the record. Go in here for the mailbox. Where are you going to split the mailbox for this? I mean, we're working with each other. I don't know what the Lord would say, you know. But, but you know.